topics is linear equation with one variable. Now, two terms you should know. What is equation? And what is variable? First of all, what is equation? Equation consists of equal sign. This equal sign, and this side of this equal sign is called left hand side, and this part of this equal sign is called right hand side. Now, in both portions, left hand side or right hand side, or one portion or any other portion, any one portion consists of variables and constant. Variables and constant numbers. Now you should know what is variable and what is constant numbers. First of all, constant numbers. Constant constant numbers, all numbers, whether fraction or whole, whether positive or negative, all numbers are constant numbers. All numbers are called constant numbers. These are, etc., all are constant numbers. What is variable numbers? Variable numbers are those numbers that are represented by any alphabet. Say X, Y, Z, or A, B, C, any alphabet can be used as variable number. Variable number means the number may be anything. Say X is equal to say 12, 13, 14. And what number represents X? That will depend upon the condition of the mathematics. Now, let us consider some problems. Say, number one, X plus 5 is equal to 12. Now, previously, as I have told, what should be the value of X? That will depend on this condition. X plus 5 is equal to 12. Now, I am giving you a small tips. One tip to solve this problem. For plus. See, this is plus 5. This is plus 5. When we transfer this 5 from left hand side to right hand side, or right hand side to left hand side, this plus sign is converted to minus 5. This plus sign is converted to minus 5. Now, your second step will be X is equal to 12. As it is plus, so it is converted to minus, and it is minus 5. So X is equal to 12 minus 5 is equal to 7. This is first tips. When a plus number is shifted from one side to another, whatever it may be, left to right or right to left, when a plus number is shifted from one side to another side, it is converted to minus term. That plus sign is converted to minus sign. Or a minus sign is converted from one side to another side. Then it is converted from minus to plus. Now next come second problem. X minus 7 is equal to
0.
0 is also a constant term. Now, previously plus sign is converted to minus. Now, minus sign is converted to plus. So, X minus 7 is shifted from left hand side to right hand side. So, minus 7 is converted to plus 7. This is X is equal to 7. Now, the value of X is 7 on this condition. In other condition, the value of X may be changed. Now, I am going to come to the third problem. Now, I am taking the third problem. That is 3x is equal to 42. Now, I am giving the third tips. That is, look very carefully. Between 3 and x, there is no sign. That indicates 3 and x is multiplied. Now, we'll have to shift this 3 from left hand side to right hand side. So, whenever a multiple sign is shifted from any other side, from other to other side, this is converted to division sign. 3 and x is multiplied, so whenever we are shifting to 3 from left hand side to right hand side, this is division, converted division, or right hand side to left hand side, this is converted to division. A multiple is always shifted his side, then it is converted division, or a division shifted his side from one side to another, this converted to multiplication. So this is equal to 3x. So x is equal to 42 divided by 3. As it was multiplied, so it is division. So this is x is equal to 42 by, this is equal to 40. This is equal to, so 14 to 3 is 14 is 42, so your answer is 40. Now you come to one most important rule. Next problem, I am showing you a most important rule. That is, let's consider this problem. X by 4 is equal to 3 by 5. How will you solve this problem? For solving this problem, we are using a rule. That is called cross cross multiplication rule. I am going to explain you about the cross multiplication rule. What is this rule? This rule is nothing. Simply, this rule is nothing. When in this format, When question is in this format, both numerator and denominator, both have a numerator and denominator. If no numerator, then that indicates 1, or if no denominator, that indicates 1. But here in this case, denominator is other than 1, so no problem arises. When problem arises, when there is no denominator in any number, that indicates that the denominator is 1. So now let's come to this problem. For solving this type of problem, denominator D E N O M E N A T Y. Denominator of left hand side into denominator of left hand side into numerator of right hand side numerator of RHS right hand side. This is always equal to denominator denominator of RHS into numerator of left hand side. This rule is applied. Denominator of left hand side into numerator of right hand side. This is equal to denominator of right hand side into numerator of left hand side. This rule is called cross multiplication. Now we apply this formula. So, x numerator of left hand side into denominator of right hand side, 5, is equal to denominator of right hand side, that is 4, denominator of left hand side, that is 4, into numerator of right hand side, this is equal to 3. So your answer will be x into 5 is equal to 12, and x is equal to, your answer is, so multiplication converted to division, so answer is 12/5. This is called cross multiplication rule. Now I come to the last example, which clearly indicates explain about the cross multiplication rule. That is, four x plus 4 divided by 3. This is equal to x plus 3. Now look very carefully. Left hand side both numerator and denominator, but right hand side have no denominator. So in this case we can write like this. is equal to x plus 3 by 1. That means x plus 3 have no denominator, that indicates the denominator of x plus 3 is 1. Now cross multiplication, according to cross multiplication rule, 3 into x, 3x plus 3 into 3 is equal to 9. Now 4x into 1 is equal to 4x plus 4 into 1 is equal to 4. So now shifting plus sign to minus sign. So 9 is shifted to right hand side. So 3x is equal to 4x plus 4 minus 9. Then this 4x is shifted to from right hand side to left hand side, that is, so as it is plus number, so 3x minus 4x is equal to 4 minus 9. Now, continuing, minus 4x, as I have teach earlier, plus 3x is equal to minus 9 plus 4. As I have teach earlier, the right first the bigger number irrespective of sign. Now give bracket, minus within bracket 4x minus 3x, again give bracket after minus 9 minus 4. So this is equal to minus x is equal to minus 5. And since both sides have minus term, so minus sign is cancelled, this is x is equal to 5.